step into my circle, my crew bunch of Urkels. Late 80s to 90s, scheming on a Heine Laura. Got a box of Pandora, feel the evil dare. Me can neither love, be lethal bird. What's the word? That at this age is absurd, but preferred. Always asking on a password, on my nerves. But ain't that the price of lovers? To leave nothing undiscovered, no one is above
Welcome
her.
Welcome to another Vlog, everyone. So I'm just out here at my favorite spot, doing a bit of morning cardio, and I guess you could say a bit of self-reflection. Throughout growing up, going to school, I went to a pretty good school. I guess you say it was private, so my parents always wanted the best for me, getting the best education possible. And then after that, the only option was to go to uni, because that's what everyone else is doing, and you just have to go with what society does, don't you? So I went to uni for 4 years, studying something that I wasn't necessarily passionate about. I had an interest in it, but I knew that once I'd finish, I'd have a secure job, and I'd earn good money. And I was really just concerned about being successful, but not necessarily doing something I was passionate about. It wasn't until I finished uni after that 4 years and actually got into the real world, started working, realizing that, you know, working for someone, you know, making them money, working on someone else's terms, wasn't my thing, you know. And I finally come to peace with like what I was passionate about and what I wanted to do with my life. And that wasn't working. Oh, actually, I was working for a property developer at the time. And that's something I can always do later on. I can always do property developments and do that on my own later on, but I just couldn't come to terms with being stuck in an office, working the 9 to 5, you know, working my ass off for someone else when I could put that time to good use and do something productive for myself. So after 2 years working that job, I decided to quit, move on, and solely dedicate myself to finding what I was truly passionate about, which was health and fitness to me. I love what I do, and it's truly changed my whole perspective on life. So I finally come at peace with my skill set and what I'm good at, and I think it's so important to know what you're good at and just going after it. And part of that is just being self-aware. So, you know, accepting your weaknesses and just staying true to your strengths and pursuing that. So that is my little chat for you guys this morning, and gonna take you guys along my day and see what we get up to. So let's do it.
I need you. I want you.
Come over here.
I need you. I want you.
Like, what's up? Then we made this while we drunk. Like, what's up? Alright. ASAP, respects to my man. Yeah, I understand. She sucked out my energy. Lord, is you testing me? Or is she really for the best of me or death of me? Give it time, I guess we'll see. Hallelujah, she drained me, but replenished me. Loving her idiosyncrasy. Nah, what I mean? A rush like caffeine. Got me addicted to a nicotine. Her love is a dopamine. But only me.
Okay, so for those watching that don't know, middle last year I quit my job, and I worked that job for 2 years. I was working as an assistant development manager for a property developer, a pretty successful one on the Gold Coast here. And I was fortunate enough to get that job straight out of uni. So straight out of uni, got put in the deep end, worked this job for 2 years. And yeah, it was a great experience. I learned a lot, but there was a lot of thought process going in about a year into my job, thinking that, you know, I'm 25 and I've got, there's so much opportunity out there, and I know that I've got a lot more to offer than working for someone else. So within that year, it obviously took a bit of time, but I decided to take that leap of faith, and if there was an opportunity to go all in with what I wanted to do, it was now. So I quit my job, and since then, I haven't looked back. Things are amazing. I've got my own successful business at the moment, so I'm very fortunate for that. But I know that because I was so passionate about what I was doing, I wasn't afraid of failure, because I knew that I'd make it work, and I knew that I could just do whatever it took to be able to, you know, live my passion and pursue what I do on a daily basis. So wake up and enjoy what I do every single day. So for anyone out there that's afraid about doing something they want to do, obviously it's hard if you don't have the income, the support to be able to go and do that. So I'd recommend, you know, doing something on the side, gradually build it up to the point where you could leave that job and pursue what you want to do. And let me ask you this question: would you continue to work that job if you won the lottery? Because I can guarantee if you won the lottery, you would quit that job you were sick of. And yeah, at the end of the day, we all need the dollar bills to be able to support ourselves and to be able to afford life. So that just gives you a whole different perspective on things. But like I said, don't be afraid of pursuing what you want to go for in life. Just give it 100%, go all in, and I can guarantee you will not have any regrets, because at the end of the day, by the time you get older, in your 40s, in your 50s, and you look back, I can guarantee you, you'll have that regret for the rest of your life, not pursuing something you wanted to go for. There's so many successful people out there doing what they're passionate about, is because they took that leap of faith, and a lot of it's to do with timing as well. The earlier you get started, the easier it becomes, and the less saturated the market is, so you just gotta go for it. And you best believe that if these people can be successful, you can too. So that is my little rant to start off the vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed it and just a bit of insight into how I'm feeling. And I know a lot of people can get a bit of value from this. So yeah, anyway, gonna get on the rest of my day and see what we get up to. All right, so it's a few hours later, around midday, and I just want to say to you guys, I'm so happy that I can finally be a lot more open on my channel and just talk to you guys about my personal life. It's something that's taken me a lot of time to work up to, and I feel comfortable doing that now. And like I was talking about before, you know, I'm truly passionate about creating content and that content influencing others to better their lives. And if I can be the person that does that, then that is what ignites my fire, and that's what keeps me motivated to do what I do every single day. So I just wanna say how grateful and thankful I am to have you guys along this journey with me, and just you guys appreciating everything I do. Right now, just actually posted a Instagram photo. So these are the struggles you have when you live on your own. You have to make use of a self timer on your camera, which I've never done before. And actually, it was a lot easier than I thought, and it makes your life a hell of a lot easier not having to rely on anyone to take a photo of you. Because that is with social media, you have to really be putting out content on a regular basis, and I've noticed that as soon as I don't do that, things drop off. You know, you need to really be producing quality content on a regular basis, almost posting, you know, daily, but it's really hard, especially with Instagram. But honestly, my favorite platform by far is YouTube, just because of the engagement. Getting to know someone on a personal level, and I honestly feel so proud when I just click that publish button and just watch the response from you guys. You know, it's a lot more satisfying as opposed to posting a photo on Instagram, but this is a photo I posted. So you can see I'm looking all happy there. I had my coffee to start the day, which you guys know is an essential part of my day. So honestly, having a strong coffee in the morning, it puts you in a good mood and literally sets the tone for the rest of the day. Because I'm a very routine person, I'm not gonna lie. Like I do really enjoy routine and the structure, and having that morning structure and that routine really does set you up for having a positive, productive day. So yeah, for any of you out there that are really, you know, wanting to be a bit more productive and have a more positive mindset, think about what you do in the morning and how that can affect the rest of your day. Something worth thinking about. But yeah, right now I'm going to make a meal, and then we're probably gonna head to the gym. It's Sunday afternoon, so that is when I like to film, because no one's really in the gym and I can take this massive tripod and camera in there without feeling like I'm being watched all the time. So that's what we're gonna do. Take you guys along with me, and yeah, let's do it. Before I leave it there, you guys are probably noticing there's a box in the corner of the frame. I'm gonna show you guys what I received this morning, if you're all curious. So I received my monthly supply of pea protein isolate, and I've had a lot of people still asking me about pea protein and why I've transitioned from whey to a pea protein isolate. And to keep it short and sweet, a plant-based protein is not gonna cause any bloating or irritability, or, you know, any intolerances that you might have with dairy or gluten, because I am gluten intolerant, especially dairy intolerant. I do bloat, and as soon as I have sort of like a whey protein shake, you feel it bloat in your stomach straight away, and it doesn't make you feel good afterwards. So it's typically why I have a plant-based protein. Same amino acid profile, same benefits, but just in a different form. On top of that, tastes a lot better than whey as well, in my opinion. It's a lot thicker consistency, and yeah, it's a lot more enjoyable for me. So been having this the last year, using my comp prep, and it honestly was the best thing ever. So if you guys want to give it a try yourself, link is in the description box below, and you can always use my discount code JERDARCO20 for 20% off. So there you go, hope you guys give it a go, and I'm gonna get on with this meal. So let's do it.
Hold up, dream with you and you was waking up with me. But this ain't love, you see, it's different than you thought it would be. Rather keep you closer, hoping that you're gonna hold up. Give me time, I'll take a second and we roast this blunt. I ain't high yet.
So that is Mill, everyone. Simple, effective, tasty, and just a staple in my diet that I have pretty much every day. So, gonna enjoy this. Macros are on screen, and yeah, probably head over to the gym. So, we'll catch you guys there. Okay, everyone, fast forward a couple of hours later, and it is now 9 p.m., so getting a bit of a late session here, but the reason I'm coming in late is because I want to film for you guys. So, yeah, putting in the effort, and fingers crossed the gym is dead so I can get this camera out and film the entire workout for you guys. So let's do it.
Writing down every word you said just to watch them go to flames. Try to break down my confidence while your bullets ricochet.
So that wraps up the workout, everyone. Safe to say I'm absolutely exhausted. It's like 10:30 right now and I never train this late. So pretty much gonna head straight home, go smash some oats, berries, and a shake, and I'll catch you guys in the next shot. That's not gonna work. All right, so it is about 4:10 on Monday and I realize I haven't wrapped up the vlog yet. So here I am wrapping things up. And before I do though, I just want to say to you guys, creating content, putting out videos on a regular basis, there's a lot of work that goes into it. And even for myself, like I realize that putting out 2 videos a week and the work that goes into that, I can't imagine doing daily uploads or every second day. And that's what I want to work up to, but I just pay my respects to everyone that does that. And yeah, I don't know how they manage life and it's tough, but I'm working towards it, getting better every time, and yeah, just want to thank you guys for watching. Something a little bit different this time around. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Until next time, I'll catch you guys in the next video.